Hello everyone, I hope you are in good health. We are starting chemistry for 12 science. It includes part 1 and part 2. Part 1 comprises of 9 chapters in total, completely based on inorganic chemistry. Part 2 comprises of organic chemistry and its concepts. We are starting right now with part 1, chapter 2, solutions, which holds the maximum weightage for your board examinations. Alright. Starting with the introduction of chapter, what do you mean by solution? The definition of solution goes in the way: a solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Now, which are the two substances? It includes solute and solvent. Solute, it is present in less quantity, and solvent, it is present in more quantity. Okay, and these two substances whose properties remain uniform throughout. Okay, so solutions can also be considered as homogeneous mixtures. Okay, homogeneous mixtures of two or more substances whose properties remain uniform throughout. Alright, solute is present in less quantity and solvent which is present in more quantity. And solvent is the only component that decides the physical state of the solutions, whether solution will be in solid state, liquid state or gaseous state. It is decided based on the physical state of the solvent. Alright, why? Because solvent is present in more quantity. Take for example. So, example goes this way. Sugar, you have taken 5 gram. You have taken water 95 gram. 5 gram of sugar, you are adding to 95 gram of water. Okay, and you are preparing a sugar solution of 100 grams. Right? According to which method? Percentage weight by weight, that is grams of solute dissolved in grams of solvent to make gram of solution. So which substance here is present in less quantity? Sugar, right? How much? 5 gram. So sugar is considered as solute, and water, what is the quantity of water? 95 gram we have taken. So water is considered as solvent, right? So solute and solvent together, it makes solution. Alright, so solution comprises of solute and solvent. Solute present in less quantity and solvent present in more quantity. Now, can you guess the physical state of this solution? Yes, you are right, it is liquid. Why? Because we have taken in which state? Liquid state, right? So solute and solvent together, it forms solution. Alright, so characteristics of solution are: particles are very small in diameter, approximately nanometer range, that is 10 raised to minus 9 meter. They are not visible. Once you dissolve sugar in water, are the particles of sugar visible to you? No. After completely being soluble, sugar is not visible to us. Particles are uniformly distributed. Particles do not settle down, just as you may see settling down in case of sedimentation, right? Particles are not separated easily by any physical means. Physical methods, which are the physical methods? Filtration, liquefaction, distillation, crystallization, centrifugation or centrifugation. You cannot separate the particles of solution by these methods. Why? Because they are completely soluble. And it is difficult to separate them due to their high solubility. Next is, do not show Tyndall effect, means scattering of light by the solute particles. As they are completely dissolved, there will be no scattering of light observed. Solution is a single phase system, means you will see single physical state, that is either solid, liquid or gas. You cannot see the two phase system. It is a single phase system, that is physical state will be uniform. Solution is stable as compared to suspension or emulsion. What is suspension? Solid in liquid. Okay, solid particles in liquid. See chalk powder in water, is it a stable thing? No, chalk powder will float. All right or sand in water, after some time sand will settle down. So that is a suspension. All right emulsion is oil in water, you can take it to different states. But solution, sugar in water, salt in water, it is stable. Right? Unlike suspension and emulsion. Suspension, solute do not dissolve, it floats. And in emulsion, it is a mixture of oil and water. Alright? Now let's move on to another topic, that is conditions of formation of solution. when can a solution be formed? First of all, we need presence of affinity between solute and solvent. What are the two components of solution? Solute and solvent. So there need to be affinity, means presence of attractive forces between solute and solvent particles. Okay. Now you know polar solute dissolves in polar solvent. Now what is polarity? That we have already studied in 11th, that is dispersal of partial positive and partial negative charges. Take for an example HCl and H2O. HCl, it is polar. You dissolve HCl in water. Let's take HCl in water. So HCl, if you see, partial positive and chlorine bears partial negative charge. Why? It is electronegative. It is electropositive, right? So this dispersion of partial charges, we call it as a concept of polarity, for those who have forgotten or those who are new. So polarity, the phenomenon of polarity, if it is present, then we call the molecules as polar. Polar solute are capable to dissolve in polar solvents only. So HCl is able to dissolve in water. You know, water, partial negative, partial positive charges, right? So dispersal of, so polar solute dissolves in polar solvent, that is water. Okay, next, non-polar solute dissolves in non-polar solvent. Example, any example of non-polar solute? Yes, you can take naphthalene, you can take camphor and naphthalene in benzene. Okay, that is an example of non-polar solute and non-polar solvent. Now here comes the important topic for your competitive exams. Molecule which has higher number of OH groups, their solubility is higher. So if you are comparing two solvents or two solutes to be dissolved in solvent, that is acetic acid, oxalic acid, in water, if you are dissolving, then solubility, whose solubility will be higher? Obviously oxalic acid. Why? It has how many OH groups? Two OH groups. So higher the number of hydroxyl groups, higher is the solubility, because it imparts more polarity to the compound. So acetic acid and oxalic acid, who will have higher solubility in water? The answer will be oxalic acid. Next is, if you compare ethanol, ethylene glycol and glycerol. Ethanol has how many OH groups? One. Ethylene glycol has how many OH groups? 2. And glycerol is having how many OH groups? 3. So who will have higher solubility? Glycerol. Why? Higher the number of OH groups, higher is the solubility. Alright. Ethanol, ethylene glycol and glycerol. These type of questions are asked in MCQs, definitely for your competitive exams. Next. Ionic solutes are soluble in polar solvents like water. Now ionic compounds means there is complete dispersion of charges. NaCl, we know Na plus NCl minus. KCl, we know K plus NCl minus. MgCl2, Mg2 plus and 2Cl minus. They are also soluble in water. Na plus NCl minus, not partial positive and negative charges as they were present in HCl, right? There is a complete dispersion of charges. Such type of compounds are called which compounds? Ionic compounds. So what can you call HCl as with the dispersion of partial positive and negative charges? Any guesses? Answer is, it is a polar covalent bond which is present between H plus and Cl minus, that is partial positive and partial negative. And here which bond is present? Ionic bond, and the compound are called ionic compounds. Alright. Now classification of solution. There are many classifications. Okay. We will study the first class, that is on the basis of solvent. On the basis of solvent, there are two categories. If the solvent is water, then it is called aqueous solution, and if excluding water, if any other solvent is being used, then it is called non-aqueous solution. Okay, so if your solvent is water, it is aqueous solution. If your solvent is any solvent except water, then it is non-aqueous solution. Non-aqueous solution generally comprises of organic solvents. Okay, so sugar in water, alcohol in water, examples of aqueous solution, because your solvent we are taking it as water. Non-aqueous solution examples: iodine in alcohol, naphthalene in benzene. All right, solutions having organic solvent. All right, second classes on the basis of number of components. We have seen basically there are two components, solute and solvent. So if only one solute component and one solvent component is present, then the solution is which solution? Binary solution. Example: sugar solution, that is sugar in water. Salt solution, salt in water. So binary solution has how many component? Two component. That will be one solute component and one solvent component. Next category is our ternary solution. That is two solute, one solvent, or one solute and two solvents. Example: sugar, salt, both together if you dissolve in water, then it is which category of solution? Ternary solution. All right. Next classification is on the basis of physical state of components. This classification is mentioned in your textbook. Okay. The above two are not mentioned, but they are asked in your competitive exams. So third class is on the basis of physical state of components. First we will take solid solution. Now we have seen that the name of solution, the physical state of solution depends on physical state of solvent. So you will notice that solid solution has which component as solvent? Solid. But solute component might change. If solute and solvent both are solid, then example is alloys like brass, bronze and gold, bronze, copper and tin, brass, copper and zinc, and gold is made up of copper and gold. Gold is also an alloy, right? Next, if solute is liquid and solvent is solid, then you will have liquid in solid solution. Okay, but physical state will remain solid, so it is called as solid solution. Examples: amalgam. When do we call a substance as amalgam? When they have mercury as a solvent. Okay, so if zinc is dissolved in mercury, sodium in mercury, how do we pronounce this as zinc in mercury, sodium in mercury? All right. Next, gas in solid. Gas will be adsorbed on the surface of solid to make a gas in solid solution, called as solid solution. Example: hydrogen on palladium, hydrogen on platinum. Next type is liquid solution. Your solute will be solid and solvent will be liquid. If solute is solid, solvent is liquid. Example: sugar in water, salt in water. If solute is liquid, solvent is also in liquid. Example: alcohol in water. If solute is gas, solvent is liquid, then we have examples of oxygen in water, carbonated drinks containing carbon dioxide in water, your soda water, the soft cold drinks that you have. All right, it is an example of gas and liquid type of solution. Okay, third category is gaseous solution, where solute may be solid, liquid or gas, but solvent is always gas. Solid in gas. Example: smoke in air, camphor in nitrogen, and dust particles in air. Liquid in gas. Example: moisture in air, chloroform in nitrogen. Gas in gas, we know air, it is a mixture of all the gases. Next class is based on solubility. Now how will you define solubility? What is solubility? The amount of solute which is dissolved in 100 grams of solvent is called solubility. You call some substances as this is less soluble, this is more soluble, this is sparingly soluble, this is partially soluble. So what exactly solubility is? The amount of solute which is dissolved in 100 grams of solvent. Alright. Now based on solubility, solutions are bifurcated into three major categories, that is unsaturated, saturated and supersaturated. Now what is unsaturated solution? So at a given temperature, the amount of solute is less than required at saturation point to be dissolved in solvent. For example, you take, I did this with an example. You take 5 gram of sugar, 95 ml of water. Don't change the composition of the solvent. Okay, we are keeping solvent composition fixed. Water we are taking here as solvent. Go on adding 5 gram, 10 gram, 20 gram. Go on adding and stir it well. Okay, there will come one particular point where no longer sugar will be dissolved. It will be precipitated down. Right? Suppose say X gram. Or let us take an example, 60 gram. At 60 gram, maximum amount of solute can be dissolved. So we can say that 60 gram is which point? Saturation point of the solution. So below saturation point, that is below 60 grams till 50 grams, okay, 5, 10, 20, 30, 40 and so on. Solution is called as which solution? Unsaturated solution, that it is contains less than the maximum amount of solute that can be dissolved. Maximum amount kitlu cha? 60 grams. Okay? Kitna hai maximum? 60 grams. So, at a given temperature, the amount of solute which contains less than the required quantity at saturation point, which is to be dissolved in solvent, is called unsaturated solution. Now, what is saturated solution? At saturation point, that is maximum amount of solute which can be dissolved at a given temperature and pressure, it is called saturated solution. Okay, super saturated solution means what? Let us continue with our previous example. 60 gram was our saturation point. We have taken how many quantity of solvent? It was 95 ml water. 60 gram is our saturation point, means beyond 60 gram if we add, it is not going to dissolve, it is going to be precipitated. So we called 60 gram as our which point? Saturation point. Okay, now do one thing. Put this beaker on Bunsen burner. Okay, ignite it. So what are now we doing? We are increasing the temperature. As you know, as we increase the temperature, what increases? Kinetic energy. So more and more solute will be dissolved now. Now this 60 gram, it will be no longer precipitated, but it will be dissolved in the solution. Okay, go on adding more. Add 65 gram. Add plus 5. That is 65 gram now. Again add plus 5. That will sum up to how many gram? 70 gram. Go on adding. At high temperature, maximum how many grams of solute will be dissolved? That is called which solution now? We can call it as super saturated solution. Okay? The gulab jambus that we make at our home, rasgulla that we make. Okay? We prepare a sugar solution. We call it as chashni, right? It is prepared on this principle of super saturated solution. Alright? Saturated solution always has a dynamic equilibrium. We had this in 11th standard, right? Chapter number 7. Solute and solvent are in equilibrium with the solution. So this one point to be added in the context of saturated solution.